Young people, what's up? How are you guys doing tonight? I don't expect you to actually answer me because you are at home and we are here. We are just about ready to do a hot wings challenge. And I'm not going to lie, I ain't even scared. Megan's a little nervous. And so I'm kind of trying to keep it cool for her. Hannah, last minute, we made her said, hey, the host in this show actually has to eat too. So she didn't know she was eating until today.
I did not know.
So we're really excited about it. But hey, we want to bring you just some word before we do this challenge. In Numbers 13, this is the story of the children of Israel. And they were about to go possess the land, and they sent out the 12 spies, and they went to the land. It was amazing. They cut some grapes off, and they came back, and they gave the children of Israel their report. And during the report, they said, yes, it's amazing, it's great, but there's giants in the land, and I'm not sure we're going to be able to really conquer the land. And the Bible says that actually they gave the children of Israel an evil report. And they were Debbie Downers. But if you go down to Numbers, verse 13, or chapter 13, verse 30, it says, and Caleb quieted the people before Moses and said, let us go up at once and take possession. Look at this. For we are well able to overcome it. You know, Caleb, and there's actually Joshua as well, they had a different kind of attitude. When everybody else was worrying, when everybody else was fretting, when everybody else was freaking out, they kind of had this attitude of like, you know what? I can do it. God can help me. It's going to be all right. Let's go do it. And the Bible says that the rest of the spies gave such an evil report that they were never going to be able to enter the land. If you go over to Numbers 14, they ended up complaining. They ended up, they started a mutiny almost. They're like, you know what? Let's kick Moses out. Let's go back to Egypt. You know, I think sometimes in mourning and in like, in bad times and tough times, you can float to your lowest common denominator. They literally thought in their mind it would be better to be slaves than to go up and try and possess the land. Go up and really do what God's called them to do. They would rather go backwards than forwards. And I just want to kind of encourage you guys, in this tough time, let's be people who want to go forwards. Let's be people who want to continue on and do what God's called us to do. And if you keep going down, and they start complaining and they start whining. And the Bible says that Moses stood in the gap for them. Really, God says, I'm going to destroy these people. And Moses is like, no, Lord, let's talk about this. And he kind of like interceded for them. And then it says that God changed his mind because he stood in the gap. Numbers 14, verse 20, it says, I have pardoned according to your word. I love that. That's a little side note thought that you can actually pray for people and God can change the whole situation around. But verse 21, it says, but truly as I live and as all the earth shall be filled with the glory of the Lord, because all these men who have seen my glory and the signs which I did in Egypt and in the wilderness and have put me to the test now these 10 times and they've not heeded my voice. They certainly shall not see the land which I swore to their fathers, nor shall any of those who rejected me see it. Basically he says, ain't none of y'all getting in. Because 10 people influenced the whole group. And we can get a lot out of this story, but you got to pay attention to who you're listening to in tough times. And I would say, how does that apply to today and right now? Pay attention to who you're listening to. What kind of report are you believing? And mind you, I want to really say this, that Caleb, it wasn't denying the facts that the giants were in the land. Sometimes I think as Christians, we think, especially faith people, that we have to deny the symptoms, or we have to deny that they are real, or listen, we fully believe in the symptoms, but we fully believe in God. We fully believe that God is well able. And you go down, and I love this. This is the point of the thought today. Numbers 14, 24, it says, but my servant Caleb, do you have your Bibles? Read it. Read along. Because he has a different spirit. I love that. Because my servant Caleb, because he has a different spirit in him, he has followed me fully. I will bring him into the land where he went, and his descendants shall inherit it. I want you to just kind of encourage you today on this Wednesday from your living room or from your device or wherever you're watching this. Let's have a different spirit. Let's be like Caleb. Let's be like Joshua. Let's be people that in the middle of adversity or maybe in the middle of tough times that we can look back and say, you know what? God's well able. God's going to be all right. We're not denying the facts. We're not denying the dangers that are real. But we're saying, you know what? We are well able. God's able to help me and sustain me through these things. I want to be a people that have a different kind of spirit. So I hope that encourages you. I hope that you, until the next time we meet, let's just be the Calebs, be the Joshuas, be the men and the women that when everybody else is freaking out, maybe when everybody else is having a bad report, notice how bad news travels fast. And that if you actually have a good report, you're almost like, you're being too optimistic, or man, let's err on the side of too optimistic. Let's err on the side of God is well able. If we're going to do anything, let's be the kind of people that have that just a different kind of spirit. And I just want to encourage you with that. And hey, if you could, while you're out there, could you give us a shout out? Could you like text message on there? Hey, we're with you. Could you actually pray? We usually pray for you, but could you pray for us right now? They did not tell us how hot these wings were going to be. I was under the impression it was like ketchup and tomato sauce, and
oops.
But I think they've changed on me. So that's my message for you today. Let's have a fighting spirit. Let's have a different kind of spirit. And Megan you, or Hannah, you guys want to chime in on that a little bit?
No, it's good.
How we can have a different kind of spirit in these tough times?
I think in the middle of quarantine and people maybe being happy that school's out or sad that they're stuck home and that everything's closed, having a bad attitude, you know, you can choose your attitude. You can choose how you're going to respond to this. And your friends will see by your attitude and by the choices that you make what kind of person you are. And so I just want to encourage you, just choose to have a good attitude, even if you're really hating being alone and not seeing your friends, even if you're hating being inside. The Bible says that David encouraged himself in the Lord.
Yeah.
And he did that through praise and worship and dancing. So put on some praise music, pray in the Holy Spirit, get your spirits lifted up, encourage yourself in the Lord if you're going through a tough time, and reach out to somebody. Like, that's what we're here. That's why we have community. That's why we have church. So reach out to somebody if you're struggling, and we'll definitely pray for you.
Yeah.
I think the thing is when the naysayers come and they say, you're just overly optimistic, you know, and you kind of come into that scenario where it's like, what do you mean you're not going to get sick? Like, you're probably going to be the first one. Mm-hmm. When that happens, the proof is in the pudding.
Yeah.
And so for me, when these kind of situations rise up, it's not just that I'm blessed for myself, right? Yeah. But it's that I'm blessed to be a blessing.
Absolutely.
So when they come and they say that, that's fine. I can I can be confident. And you know what? At some point, I hope to bless you in the middle of this. And at the end of this, I will have a testimony to share with you, because the proof is in the pudding.
Yeah.
And so it's not just me saying those things in the beginning. It's not just me saying, no, I'm going to be okay. I'm not going to get corona. Like, you know, it's not just me having confidence. No, I don't care if I get laid off. Like, my bills are still going to be paid. Yeah. My needs are still going to be met. But it's consistently keeping that confession of faith. And then at the end, the proof is in the pudding.
Yeah.
And I'm going to do my best to bless you in this.
Yeah.
Different kind of spirit.
Yes.
Young people, I think this is a really good time for the church to shine. This is a really good time for us not to be freaked out. People have freaked out, buying all the toilet paper, buying all the food, and it's just important for us to just have a different kind of spirit. We're not denying the facts. We're not in la la land. We're not denying science. We're not even speaking against quarantine. Hey, quarantine. If we can help some people, let's do it. But it's just a different kind of spirit that says we are well able to possess the land. And really, now we're not trying to possess any land. What we're trying to do is possess the promises of God and really walk in His fullness. And so we hope that you do that. And if you're in fear today, I would encourage you to change who you're listening to.
Yeah.
And not that you need to shut them up or tell you know, I would just put good in. And I would encourage you to listen to, go find some Brother Hagin on YouTube. Go find some good preaching on no fear. Get in your word. Look up fear in the Bible and like read every scripture when it has what it has to do with fear. Yeah. And just kind of reprogram yourself to say, you know what, I'm not. It's not just about denying the fear. It's about literally you have to put confidence in. You have to put something else in. And so I would do that. And you need to understand that fear is not of God. The Bible says that he's not given you a spirit of fear, but of power of love and a sound mind. So in this troubled time, in this real danger time, we can have peace, we can have joy, and we can have we can be people who have a different spirit. That's right. So, all right, without further ado, drum roll, please. We are going to begin our Hot Wings Challenge. And so what happens now is Hannah's going to kind of take over. And I don't even know what this is going to look like. I need you to pray for us. Maybe just pray in tongues the whole time as we eat these, especially number five. And we're just going to have a good time tonight. Go for it, Hannah.
Well, thank you both for agreeing to participate in this. This shows your trust in me.
Yeah.
And, you know, I will do my best to go through this with you fearlessly. And if I'm a little afraid, well, help my unbelief. how this is going to work is we're going to eat some hot wings while we ask you some questions. So the wings get hotter and hotter each level. We have five different wings.
I ain't even
scared. Last one will be the hottest of all. And let me tell you, that's going to be an experience. So the first question for you here, the first wing that we're going to be eating is just a traditional hot wing.
I
know that it says hot, but we're starting off pretty easy here. So we're going to go ahead, take a bite of this, and then we'll get going on our questions.
My wing's cold.
Do I get
Erica? Microwave them wings.
So you know what? I've never had a wing with so much sauce on it. Wow, I'm going to go the other side.
Very mild.
Oh, this is good.
It's all over my face, though. I'm gonna be saucy for days.
I'm gonna finish this one.
All right, go ahead.
So this hot wing. Oh wow, that's kind
of
spicy.
I just thought in the back of my throat.
It's a little lip tingle.
Maybe I won't finish this one.
It just like makes your lips tingle a little bit.
Wait, I licked my fingers.
All right.
During the coronavirus.
Oh, wow. Maybe don't do that. So I have a picture to show you. We can go ahead and put that up there.
Oh, my gosh.
Pastor
Is that
Megan,
Sydney?
Pastor Megan, do you remember what was happening in this picture?
Oh, my gosh. I have no idea.
You were learning to play guitar. There's me in my hat. I know that.
Yeah, you're sitting there. It looks like we're holding hands. Maybe we're praying.
Are we praying
so that we could hold hands?
Oh, okay. All right. Let's go ahead and put up the next picture, which is the other side of this. This is the other angle.
We weren't praying.
Pastor Nate is painting Pastor Megan's toes. So, Pastor Nate, your question is, do you still paint Pastor Megan's toes now that you're married?
No.
That is the only time that has ever happened.
That's the only time. All right.
Oh, my gosh.
If I accidentally throw away number four and mix it up, is that a problem?
No. Yeah, that's not going to be how this goes.
Dude, that was kind of spicy already, guys.
Okay, so we're just throwing these away. I might want to come back and eat
it. We can go ahead and throw these away. All right, the next wing that we're moving on to is Jammin' Jalapeno.
Oh, wow.
This one's getting a little bit hotter, but it is definitely not quite up on the scale yet. But I will say that this is one of the ones I have not tried.
So Jammin' Jalapeno, where are these from? Just so that our sponsors will know.
You know, most of them are from Buffalo Wild Wings.
Most.
Okay. Don't worry about it.
So actually, this is called a challenge.
That one's good.
This is called a challenge because we want to see who...
I like that one.
Is out of Megan and I, who's going to quit sooner, or we're all going to finish?
Oh, we're all going to finish. But
who's
going to
be affected more?
We'll see who's a little more dramatic along the way.
That one's good.
All right.
Oh, that's not even spicy.
Yeah, I like that one.
Yeah.
That one should have been number one.
Yeah. I know, that one's really not quite as spicy.
I mean.
All right. Question number two.
It's more. Oh, never mind. Oh, it's coming now.
What?
Are you
serious?
Yeah.
Okay.
That was a little
What
better.
Is the most dangerous game What is the most dangerous game you ever played with the youth?
It was like sweet, honey.
This is for both of you.
Dangerous?
Oh. The most dangerous game.
Dude, can I just talk to youth pastors right now?
Please.
When I was first, so we've been doing youth ministry for, 15, 16 years, right? So when we first, sauce on my jacket. When we first got started, you just want to have fun, and we were in a parking lot of a church. We didn't even have like grounds. We didn't have like grass and soft things that the young people could fall in. So we were doing somebody jumps on their back and runs. And we had this girl visiting. She was like her first time there, and obviously she's on the back of her boyfriend. I remember being at the end and they had to like touch my hand or something stupid. Yeah. I'm like, come on, let's do it.
Wasn't she on his shoulders though?
Yeah, no, she was holding on to his, no, she wasn't, she was on his shoulders. Back? Like it was just a piggyback ride. She's run. And literally it was like 15 feet away from me and I saw the frontal and she's holding on. And her arms are, I think, were underneath, or basically, there's no way for her to stop her fall because her hands were around. And I remember him just falling over, and it was her face that hit the ground first. She lost teeth. Yeah. And then it was like years later, I read this book, and now I have all the interns read it. It's called Better Safe Than Sued. And it inspired me. We ask ourselves now and during any youth event, can anybody get hurt through this thing? Can anybody die? And if the answer is...
Can they lose any teeth?
Yeah.
The answer is we're not doing it.
Thankfully, she was awesome, and we just had to give her some new teeth, and she was good to go.
Wow. Needless to say, she didn't attend very long.
The relationship didn't last very long.
Wow.
All right.
Do you agree that was the most dangerous game you ever played?
That was the one that popped up in my head.
Yeah. There was another time in youth ministry where we were... whitewater rafting. Funny things happen in youth ministry that they don't tell you about when you're a youth pastor. We're taking 30 kids down whitewater rafting, and we're like, yeah, it's going to be great. And this kid, I kid you not, we are walking down to the river. You kid, if you're watching, you know who you are. We were walking down to the water, and he's like, hey, Pastor Nate, by the way, I don't know how to swim. Wait, what? You don't know how to swim? Like, he's like, yeah, I don't know how to swim. Why are you going on a whitewater rafting trip, bro? And he says, well, I didn't think I had to swim. And so basically, he could get, and then guess what? The first rapid that we take, that boat, I was like, all right, get him with me. And that boat capsized. We went in. And literally, I was like, at one point, I was like, coming up out of the water, I was like, okay. And our guide was amazing, and she somehow rode the boat. It flipped over. She got on top of the boat right away and grabbed him right up because she knew that he couldn't swim. I told her. And so everybody was accounted for, and it turned out great. But
you let him on the boat still.
Better safe than sued.
He had a life jacket on. We were walking
to the boat. There was no way. Like we were dropped off from the bus. And so, it was wild.
All right, so wing number three.
Oh, boy.
This is something that Erica used to eat back when she ate spicy food. But it definitely gives you a mouth tingle, maybe
scared.
A little more.
What's this one called?
This one is called mango habanero. So it has a little bit of sweetness to it, but the heat is definitely there.
Okay, so can the audience know when we're allowed to drink milk?
Ideally, you don't. So if you do, I'm going to make fun of you a little bit.
Okay.
Here Why are these so full of sauce?
I know, they're so saucy.
What kind of restaurant is this? All right. I wanted to see your reaction first.
I'm scared, guys.
That's not all right. What is this, a joke?
No, it's hitting.
That one's not spicy.
There's a little spice.
I take it back. My mouth tickle.
I think they're gonna like get us to the end of these, and this is gonna be like ketchup. They're gonna be like, "We got you."
No, that one had a little spice to it.
That one.
All right.
That was comparable to the second. Comparable.
So I'm gonna show you guys a video, And I want you to explain why you chose to film this and why you showed it to the youth.
I know what you're
so let's go ahead and watch this
I
video.
I know exactly which one you're going to
Hi, Rhonda.
Hi.
So, I was thinking.
Yeah.
You know, we've been dating really for a long time now.
I know, it's almost a month.
I know. Can't believe it. But so, I was just thinking maybe it's time to, take our relationship, further.
Really?
Yeah.
Aww.
I love you so much.
I love you too.
Little googly bear.
Little snickums. Wait. You really do love me, right? You're not just using me.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, I love you.
Really?
I know I love you.
Oh, I love you too.
I would like to say that at the end of this video, also, I saw no context for this. I found this on Chris's YouTube, and I was horrified. It's like watching your parent.
Yeah.
So at the end of this, you see their silhouettes, their chairs lean back, and all you hear is kissing sounds. And meanwhile, I'm alone screaming, going, what did I find?
We did show this to our youth ministry.
Yeah.
This is true.
So what was the point of this? What was the idea?
To not lie
it?
To your parents about who you are and who you're hanging out with and what you're doing so that you tell the truth.
We were demonstrating what not
what
to do.
What not to do when we were married.
It wasn't complicated.
So.
Yeah, we were married.
Next wing.
Right. Scale of 1 to 10, would you film that again?
Yeah, I don't know.
Oh, wow.
Maybe. I would make one
that,
of you guys film
I will
film
say,
it.
Though, that series was no. so good.
It was
a
very,
very
good, series.
Good series. No lies, no secrets.
No lies, no secrets.
And that's how we live our lives today, still. No lies, no secrets.
All right. So this is wing number four, which
number
is
four.
The last Buffalo Wild Wings wing.
That's
being
right.
that,
it
is
I feel like
called
I'm halfway through.
Their Blazin' Wing, which is the hottest wing that Buffalo Wild Wings carries.
Okay.
Oh
so, not to make you nervous at all, but let's
my lips
go ahead
are burning already.
Dude, there's a lot of sauce on
I
this.
I know. She's
okay.
Saucy.
Yeah.
Like,
I've never been to any place with
that
this,
has
much,
this
sauce.
Much sauce on it. I'm about ready to take my wipey and like wipe it off.
I know.
I'm like,
okay,
come on, here we go.
Eat with my.
Oh my gosh,
fingers.
I'm nervous.
I ain't scared.
Okay, do it, babe.
Oh, wow. Okay. Oh, that's hot. Seriously? Did you not get a spicy one? Did you guys not give her spicy ones?
All right.
Yeah, it wasn't that bad. I'm good.
How are you doing, Hannah?
It's hitting me in the back of the throat, man.
Yeah. That's not,
oh. Okay. We're going to move on. All right, so, Pastor Megan, if you had to be on the show, My Strange Addiction, what would you be on the show for?
Okay. That's hot. It's like under my tongue is burning.
Y'all are...
Nose
oh my running. Gosh.
Okay, My Strange Addictions, what would you be on the show for?
Oh my gosh, that's hot.
Okay, I can do it.
Okay.
I'm never doing this again.
What would you be on the show for?
I'm crying.
Picking my toenail polish off.
Okay, let's go ahead and put this picture up, and I want to know if your answer is the same. This is a picture. of Pastor Megan back in the day licking a shoe. So I want to know, are you sure that you wouldn't be on My Strange Addictions
for
shoe licking?
I have not licked a shoe since then, so no. Oh my gosh, my lips are burning.
My eyes are watering. Okay, Pastor Nate. Pastor Nate, your
I've
question.
I've never had something so spicy.
Oh my gosh.
Pastor Nate, your question. Have you ever experienced bullying?
I think I'm drooling. My mouth is so numb, I'm drooling.
Don't touch your eyes. Have you ever experienced bullying?
Oh my gosh.
I've experienced bullying?
Yeah, have you ever?
Never.
Not been a participant, but experienced
bullying. I've been a participant only.
Okay, let's put up the next picture.
Oh, wow.
Are you sure? Because this picture looks like you were experiencing it.
Oh my goodness, guys, these are hot.
These are hot.
What came from, what happened
oh my gosh.
That caused
What were
this?
We doing? I have no
idea. This was
idea.
A video. We were making a movie. This was a video with Chris. We were filming a video. And that is ketchup.
All right.
That's ketchup okay. on your face.
No, I was going to say none of this is ketchup.
So.
Feisty.
No.
I wish it was ketchup.
Oh my gosh, you guys. This is so hot.
Here's the thing, guys.
We I'm good.
Have
I'm good.
A challenge
I'm
with
good.
This
Hannah.
Game. Woo! Woo!
It's like
is
hot
a challenge
in here. It's hot
at
in
the
here.
End of this game, where we like to put a little extra on the last.
No,
game.
She put extra
this
on it.
This one is the bomb.
It
this
is?
One.
What? I
you have
the
bomb.
So, oh my gosh, you liars!
So here's the thing. I was a little concerned because they said online that there was some varying in Buffalo Wild Wings sauces. So I bought us some insurance. And I can guarantee you, because we made our video man, Chris, try this sauce, and there were some instant repercussions. Now, you don't have to put a little extra on.
Oh, okay.
Oh my gosh.
Stop
but
it.
Oh my
if
like
I'm doing it.
My glasses are fogging up, you guys.
But if I'm doing it and you don't, I'm going to make fun of you.
I'm actually okay, really
I'll
good. I'm good right now.
I'll do it.
I'm good. It's so... It's, I don't.
Beyond insanity. Oh my gosh. This is so dumb. That like the tiny
the bomb.
Bit.
It like
this
gives
is
you
already
this
on here
hot
though,
sauce,
right?
It gives you like instant
this hot
burps.
Sauce has a warning on it that you must be 18 or older and not pregnant to
Are
eat this.
Serious?
Wait, I might be pregnant.
All right.
Okay, oh my gosh.
The fact that you guys are putting this on, I say no.
Then we're going to
we're going to make
fun
of you for
and
forever.
You won't have done it.
Okay, why are we doing this?
I don't know,
this is
but
not even Jesus related, guys.
I'm just going to do it. I am done. Let's just
oh,
get
no.
it over with.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Is this the you got one more question. Oh my gosh, Megan Elizabeth, why are you like this?
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
Why did we do this?
That's like a burn.
Okay. I was just watching you guys.
Oh my gosh.
Help.
That is so hot.
Oh.
It's the weirdest hot in the world.
I swallowed it before.
No, wait for it.
Oh my.
All right.
All right. Oh my gosh.
What was your most embarrassing moment as a teenager?
Oh, oh my
Pastor
goodness.
Megan.
It's like down in my belly.
It burns!
Oh no.
I seriously might throw up.
Oh my gosh, who does this? Why would anyone do this?
Most embarrassing moment as a teenager.
Most embarrassing moment, baby.
Oh my gosh. I don't have one. My most embarrassing moment as a child was when
my Lanta.
I potted my pants in school.
So how do you get rid of this?
Oh, my gosh.
What's
it
your most embarrassing moment at home?
I don't remember. I cry all the time.
Oh, my
as
gosh.
A child. I'm going to do. Okay.
Oh, my gosh.
All right. You have 30 seconds.
You guys.
Look into the camera, Pastor Nate.
This is so
tell
hot.
Tell them anything you want to tell them. And we're going to wrap up this trade. And I'm going to go pass out.
I'm going to. We love you. Love you. Bye. Oh.
Adios, familia.
Don't ever do this. Don't ever do this.
It
this
hurts
is horrible.
So much.
It's so hot.
Okay.
Bye, I love you
see
all.
See you guys.
Oh my gosh.
How do you?
I need more milk.
How do you end this?
It is so hot. It's like a bomb in your mouth.
Oh.
It hurts so bad. Someone help.
I am literally crying.
Oh my God.
Oh my gosh, it burns. Oh! Oh my gosh. Why?
Wow.
You okay?
We need bread. Like white bread.
Okay, you want ranch? You want more milk? What do you want?